Muhammad Ramazanov. And introducing his opponent out of the red corner. He stands at 5 feet 11 inches tall, weighing in at 184.25 pounds, holding a mixed martial arts record of 20 wins and 3 losses. Training out of UFD Gym, representing Croatia, Roberto RoboCop Soldic. And when the action begins, your referee in charge, Mr. Herb Dean.
All right, gentlemen, we've been over the rules. Protect yourself at all times. Follow my instructions. Gonna keep it clean. Touch gloves, let's do it.
Final instructions, Herb Dean, here we go. Finally, the opportunity to see the great Roberto Soldic in the one circle.
I just gotta say, in the face-off, most guys kind of stand square, and Soldic was already in the southpaw stance, looking like he was ready to throw a strike in the face-off.
Here we go, the hottest free agent in the world joins one championship, Roberto Soldic, the Croatian. And here he is tonight. He's got a tough draw for his opening fight here in one.
Yeah, he couldn't ask for a tougher opponent, and that's exactly what he wanted. He wants to fight the best, to be the best, and we're getting to see exactly what Soldic has to offer. Ramazanov's trying to reach forward with that hand, faking level changes. We know exactly what Ramazanov wants to do. He wants to enter into that single leg and chain wrestle his way to a takedown finish.
I tell you, Ramazanov actually has a really nice jab, and if he would just hide that thing behind his wrestling and his shots the whole night and kind of keep Soldic guessing at what he's going to do, he could have an effective stand-up game tonight, actually.
Nice inside leg kick landed by Soldic. He does a great job of cutting his opponents off and staying right in front of him.
Two world title fights still to come, but you were as excited or more excited about this one.
Yeah, exactly, with good reason, too. These are two of the highest level welterweights in the world. Ramazanov did a great job of getting the entry into the single, transitions to the double, puts Soldic down. Soldic is doing a good job so far of maintaining his base. Now we're gonna see Ramazanov try to circle him off of the wall, peel him back, and then try to put him flat on the mat.
Yep.
Soldic needs this wall, right? He needs to utilize that cage wall so he can start working his way back up. But Ramazanov does such a good job of sucking your hips away from the fence, so you're slowly getting away from the wall so you can't use it to get back up.
Yeah, Soldic is doing a good job of not allowing him to do that. Ramazanov has one hand around the back there and the other one on the knee trying to pull him out. You can see Soldic is doing a good job here of walking his hips right back up that wall.
That was nice. That was good. This is what Soldic says. He says he's very comfortable in these positions. He has no fear of going to the ground with Ramazanov, but ultimately he doesn't want to stay there. He wants to keep it on the feet and strike. And Soldic did a really good job of working his way back up.
Oh, a low shot to the groin area of Soldic. Obviously, Ramazanov didn't mean to do it, but that is...
Yeah, that's the thing about groin shots, is they take a little while to fully set in. You'll hear the impact, you'll feel it, but then it just gets worse as time goes on.
It's similar to a liver shot, Brent. If you've ever watched a match, a boxing match or anything, you see a guy get hit in the liver or the body, and it just takes a few seconds until that system shuts down. Similar thing could happen here. And you can hear the sound of the cup, circle side.
He's got a full 5 minutes to try to recover.
Yeah, Soldic is in a world of pain right now. I mean...
Let's listen in as we show you the replay here. Here it is.
And Soldic did a really good job working his way back up.
Oh, a low shot. Yeah, you could hear it. We could hear it.
Does that sound plastic to you?
Yeah, we're back to that. I don't think he's wearing a tie cuff. I should just send out a blast email to every athlete on our roster. Tie cuffs, guys, get the steel tie cuffs.
The steel cuffs, you know, they don't feel good. You know, they don't feel like, it's not like you feel nothing, but there's so much more protection when you have a tie cup on. It's basically just like a steel cup. It's pretty much like
concrete.
It's a little chalice.
Quick thing. He's got a full 5 minutes. Obviously not a laughing here, but the situation here, even if he's able, and he doesn't look like he's able to keep going, we hope he can, even if he's able to, how much does that play into the back of your mind here?
I think if you actually shake it off, once you shake it off, you're good. But what ends up happening with a groin shot is it ends up taking a lot of wind out of you. And it's difficult to recover from these things. Like, you think you're okay, and then you get into it, and suddenly a half a round later, it'll cost you like your gas tank. But what the rule here on this is that once you're fouled, if there's an incidental foul, there's no red flag given on this, or no yellow card given on this thing. So this is just an incidental foul. It's accidental. If something like this were to continue to happen a second or third time, that's what would cause a yellow card or a red card. But once someone is injured, you have the duration of a round, so you have 5 minutes to recover from this. This is just unfortunate because this is Soldic's debut, and I'm 100% certain that he didn't.
Herb Dean just called it off.
Wow.
He can't continue.
Well, on this, so we haven't reached the midpoint of the match yet. It would not go to the judges' scorecard. This will automatically just be a no contest.
I mean, you can tell Ramazanov feels terrible about it. At the same time, he wants Soldic to be able to continue and pull off a huge win here. But Soldic can't do it. Herb Dean waved it off, and that's it.
I mean, yeah, you want to be tough. Yeah, you want to go out there and put on a show. But ultimately, I mean, you're in there against one of the dangerous welterweights in the world. If you're not 100%, you have to make that decision. Sometimes your heart overrides your head. But in this case, Soldic is... No, you got to make sure you're okay. And he's also a warrior, too. Yeah. If he wasn't okay, you know.
So it's going to be a no contest. Meantime, we kick off the new year in Bangkok. One on Drive Video 6. The main event, Superman and Alazov for the featherweight kickboxing world title.